Namaste, angels. I'm here to do a client reading, and the reading I'm going to do is for someone I believe I may have done a reading already, but I didn't feel like looking to see whether I had or not. Just wanting to get fresh energy either way, and then I can always send her the original one should I locate it later or feel the need to look it up later or whatever. So I'm just going to get right into it. Beginning with the High Priestess, Archangel Haniel. Listen to your intuition. Have patience. Consider carefully what you want before acting. And I believe she is a Gemini. So this card would be appropriate, at least in my opinion. I can't speak for other tarot readers because most people would say that this is a water sign. And it may be a water sign. However, the High Priestess is a Gemini. And the number 2 stands for the sign of Gemini. The Roman numeral 2 is the symbol for Gemini, and the High Priestess is a Gemini. The end. So, this could very well be representing the feminine right out of the gate. And opening to the 8 of Earth, skilled work is rewarded, learning all there is to know about a topic, and maybe even going back to school, which could be appropriate for her. One of the reasons for which I just wanted to do a fresh reading is that she had been laid off from her job before. So the 8 of Earth was back just now, opening down to the 4 of Earth. And when that happens, it tends to be because we either didn't... we either missed and or, you know, like we missed and or ignored direction from the universe to leave our job and maybe to pursue something more spiritual, certainly to pursue our life's purpose instead. So like when we fail to do it ourselves for whatever reason, even if it's, you know, innocently, we just didn't realize what we were being guided to do. The universe does it for us in the form of a tower. The 4 of Earth is back. Go one more. Opening now to the 3 of Water, a celebration, a wedding, graduation, or birth announcement, and the need to have more fun. This 4 of Earth back though. So being too frivolous or too cautious with money. Maybe she's holding on tightly to it because again, she had lost her job. She might be concerned about finances from where they're gonna come in the future and things like that. But she, it's possible she's also making good business decisions right now, and even giving to those less fortunate. Can mean all those things. I connect it to love as well. We can be, you know, and that can be this happy romantic love. It can just be love in general. We can hold on to love too tightly or give it too freely to people who don't necessarily deserve it. And in that respect, as far as love being a form of abundance, I'm burning, by the way, a pink candle here. And this is like for Venus and for Archangel Chamuel, both of which represent love and money, or, you know, abundance in both of those forms. Archangel Chamuel, the archangel of unconditional love and abundance and lost things as well. Maybe like the reading. And Venus, governing both finances, money, material wealth, and love. You know, being the goddess of love and ruling the signs of Taurus, so material things. And also Libra. So fairness and balance and all of that is certainly a form of love. Maybe not romantic love, but giving of yourself and being equitable and fair and diplomatic, and all these are all the signs of love toward our fellow man, treating people properly. And to speak of the tower, that's what the overall energy of this reading is. Life experience, and to speak of Archangel Chamuel, life experience with Archangel Chamuel, a significant life event, a powerful revelation that leads to change, time to spread your wings. something just jumped out. It is the Three of Water. So I'll leave this here as an additional overall energy, joining the Tower or life experience. Masculine is the Two of Earth. Too much going on at once. The need to make a decision. Consider a more playful approach. This has been typical of the masculine in general lately for the collective. And the Knight of Fire. And I believe he's a Sagittarius, so this would be appropriate as well. Passionate, adventurous, self-assured, and restless is the Knight of Fire. He is also a Sagittarius. Leo or Aries. A sudden event that needs immediate attention. Time is of the essence. Think things through carefully. And the Knight of Air for the feminine's Gemini, maybe, or he might have some in his chart as well, some Gemini, Libra, or Aquarius. Intelligent, decisive, idealistic, and tireless, other than being an air sign, is the Knight of Air. Events that occur with great speed. Take time to carefully review your options. You can come up with creative solutions if you do. And the feminine is the Ace of Air. Brilliant new ideas and inspirations. Seeing the truth of a situation. A challenging beginning is possible. The Ace of Air also represents victory. And she is surrounded by the King of Earth, who is generous, professional, responsible, and practical. A successful time. Confidently accept opportunities you're offered. So if you're still looking for work and it's coming your way, you're being offered potential jobs, you're not sure, Spirit says, take them. You have the Midas touch. And you may have some earth in your chart. It's possible. Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. And in your subconscious, the Page of Earth, who is scholarly, dependable, patient, and successful. Good news about financial matters. Wanting to do something more challenging and a new area of study. So this is the second time we've seen the card of potential study. We began with the Eight of Earth. You may be wanting to go to school, whether you've realized it yet or not. Maybe still be a subconscious thought. Next to the Ace of Air, which I just said means victory, is the Six of Fire, which also represents victory. Good news is on its way. Public recognition or awards. That's crowning the union. At the root, the Three of Earth, the power of creativity. Recognition for very high quality work. Be a team player. This can be the boss having his eye on you, or the masculine at work, the Three of Earth. It's very similar to the Judgment card in that sense. And diagonal tier to the King of Earth and the Page of Earth, you know, it can have something to do with that. If not at work, somewhere else where somebody has an opportunity to reward you, maybe with an offer or something, is where they're keeping an eye on you. At the heart of the matter, justice with Archangel Raguel. Fair and just decisions. Do what you know is right and stand up for your beliefs. So the Three of Earth, you know, also means for me a possible, what I call a quote unquote party of three. It means a third person involved somehow, some way in the union. And now this is your second three, this Three of Earth. Because remember, the Three of Water took a flying leap out of the deck as I was shuffling. That can be what this is. Somebody needs a divorce. Maybe both people. I mean, it's at the heart of the matter. So it's possible. Maybe that's what the challenging beginning is going to be about, you know, trying to start over on one's own as opposed to, you know, with a mate. The masculine having a decision to make, it's a decision with regard to earth matters. So it can have something to do with work, but it can have something to do with marriage or cohabitating and stuff like that as well, because it's about like, where am I going to live? With whom am I going to live? How am I going to live? All that kind of stuff it can be. Two of Earth. Also could be like trying to balance work and home. Like, I, you know, all work and no play makes Jack a dull boy. how do we, you know, manage that? Also being diagonal here to justice can have something to do with a decision to go after something that belongs to him or not. Maybe having to pursue it legally. You know, maybe having to file suit against someone or some sort of entity or something in order to recoup what's his. If he did, it would like be victorious. Whatever this potential legal situation is, it's crowned again, as is the union as a whole, by the Six of Fire, which is victory, and diagonal to further victory here with the Ace of Air. Let's see if we can get clarity. I'm gonna take the top card from here to attempt to get clarity on the Three of Earth. It's the Four of Air and the need to rest or even take a vacation and to perhaps allow more time before making a decision. Meditation may provide answers. So again, perhaps trying to figure out what to do about a third party, whether it's romantic involvement or some other way that they're sticking their head, not only their head, but their energy into this situation. It's otherwise a very nice spread. I'm not really a fan of the Two of Earth in general. Let me see if I can clarify that one. It's being clarified by the Eight of Earth and skilled work being rewarded. So maybe somebody at work trying to like take his idea, you know, and thereby like his bonus, his reward, his credit. Skilled work is rewarded. Also learning all there is to know about a topic and going back to school. Could be something having to do with getting the money to go back to school too. I pulled one other. It's the Knight of Earth also, who is loyal, dedicated, honorable, and kind. Time to buckle down and get things done. Honor your commitments. You have a guardian angel. So it looks like it's about him having to pursue someone or something in order to get what's due him. Some sort of monetary or material reward in that regard. Let's get some advice for the two of you in general from here. I also wanted to do for you a life purpose spread, beginning with healer. You have the spiritual gift of healing and the desire to share it with others. Now, healing comes in many, many forms. You know, a painter is a healer. You don't have to lay hands on people. You know, an author is a healer. A singer is a healer. A dancer is a healer. Yes, healers look like this too. You know, they're doctors. They're people that lay hands on you. They're massage therapists. They're, you know, Reiki practitioners. They're tarot readers, a few of us. Unfortunately, many that you'll see are not healers. They're damagers. They're hurters. Because they weren't called to really do this, and they're doing it for other reasons. It's unfortunately not like one of these or the others that I mentioned, where it has to be evident that you're for real in order for you to get by doing it. That's the sad part. But my point was that healing comes in many, many forms. So we'll see what forms come up for you here. Beginning with nutrition. You conduct healing work with your culinary skills. Now that can be, I think of many, many things when I think of nutrition. You know, I don't just think of food as far as healing, but also like herbs, right? Somebody who's capable of mixing herbs together, even aroma therapy, the smells that come from heating up organic foods and things. They're edible and they can help us to heal in other ways as well. Opening now to justice, more justice. So maybe, again, somebody's due some money from their job. And it looks like more so the masculine because he had a decision to make. But, I mean, you know, this justice is diagonal to your money, too. And next to it. So maybe you both are. Maybe the job didn't pay you, you know, the package or whatever that you were due, the, you know, some sort of entitlement. Maybe they're holding up your 401k or something that they owe you. And it's time, spirit is directing you to, you know, move on it and get it from them. Even if they, if you don't feel they're doing something, you know, necessarily illegal, if you've left funds in the, you know, sort of care and management of somebody with whom you know you no longer otherwise have a relationship, you're being guided now to completely sever that and go after what's yours, you, both you and the masculine. So it can really be like a closed and ended relationship, you know, with whomever it is or whatever type of relationship it is. Romantic, professional, whatever, it doesn't matter. Coming to the end of your family. Loving your friends and family is central to your life purpose. And that just goes to, at a minimum, the fact that when we're happy and we're exuding love, that's what comes back to us. And we help to like sort of breed it all over the place because it's catching, you know, smiles and things like that. So I'm going to put here what you can do for yourself, then surrounding and what spirit wants you to know, okay? And then what specifically Archangel Michael wants you to know, the overall energy is environmentalist. You're an earth angel who was born to protect, nurture, and teach about nature and the animals. This can be easily connected to nutritionists even. You know, maybe an environmentalist, somebody who goes out into the, maybe not in the traditional sense that we think of, maybe someone who goes out into nature, especially with all this earth that popped up in this reading. Somebody that goes out into nature and picks, you know, these plants and weeds, and again, knows how to boil them, cook them, where they become a medicine, they become therapeutic for someone in some way. Well, coincidentally, right on top of that too, so maybe this is you today. Maybe you're the masculine today. Right on top of that Two of Earth, which can certainly signify the need for a decision to be made, although I didn't ask that these cards match up and I wasn't necessarily expecting them to, is another question or another, you know, it's time to decide. Make a decision based on your heart's true desires. Crystals. Your connection to crystals and gemstones is a channel for healing energy. Now, this can be a career, you know, possibility, and or just to heal yourself. I'm surrounded by crystals. You know, this is just some of my jewelry. But on top of that, I got all kinds of crystals here. Many too big for me to pick up right now. That I'm just constantly healing myself, like always, and healing the energy around me. I never want it funky. And again, that goes to breeding more happiness and more, you know, peace and tranquility. If I feel that way, a person that I touch, whatever way, you know, doesn't have to be a physical touch, but a person with whom I come into contact and share that with, they can feel the same way. Builder. Your innate ability to build and create things. It brings you a deep sense of accomplishment. This can mean so many things. You know, just about anything can be built upon. Surrounding you. School. So now this is the third message about perhaps going back to school, taking them some sort of a vocation. And it doesn't have to be a physical school building that you walk into. You may just learn a trade underneath someone else or online or however you want to do it. But In any case, this is the third again indication that the answer that you're seeking involves going to school. And teaching, maybe sharing what you learn, or this can be the teacher that you find, you inspire, and maybe you're going to turn around and help people that are younger, going to help children. You inspire young people to learn. Maybe they're just going to look up to you. Maybe these are your own children. And the fact that mommy went back to school is inspiring to them. Spirit wants you to know. Oracle cards. You are able to discern answers and guidance for yourself and perhaps others. Very nice. Whatever you do, practice is going to be required. Polish your skills by practicing regularly. And you have oracle cards underneath school. So, well, this could be one part of it, one version, because I always say that this is like school, you know, school, church, whatever. So this can be one part, the spirit sort of co-signing and saying, yes, you've taken the first step. And another thing can be if perhaps you're too... if oracle cards don't come naturally to you, you're to take up some sort of class, some sort of mediumship class or something. I personally don't prescribe to that, any of that kind of stuff, or necessarily believe in it. I don't believe that, you know, like natural ability can be taught. But if you have some, it can certainly be built upon, right? Expanded, expounded upon. So yeah, maybe you're supposed to take up some sort of class involving oracle cards. And spirit also says, trust your feelings and dreams to guide your career path. The heart of the matter for you, you're becoming more sensitive and need to make changes accordingly. So you can't try to continue to live in the same box you did in the past. You know, so, you know, think big and think with your heart and then follow that. Let's get your romance spread underway. I'm just being kind of lazy in some ways and not taking this other stuff up. We're going to begin with getting to know each other. As you reveal your innermost selves to each other, your bond deepens. Opening two, heart-to-heart conversations. This is a great way to reveal your innermost selves to each other. Honestly discuss your feelings with one another. Heart-to-heart conversations is back. Opening now to soulmate. Yes, this is your soulmate. Always a pleasure to see that in a love reading. Heart-to-heart conversations back. And chemistry. There's a strong magnetic attraction here. And after all of that, getting to know each other is back. The overall energy is playfulness, which comes pretty naturally to a Gemini and to a Sagittarius, actually. They're both, quote unquote, immature signs. This is perfect. They also mirror one another. Sagittarius and Gemini are mirror signs. To recapture romance, allow your inner youthful spirit of fun to shine. Masculine is separation. Time apart from your partner is on the horizon. Surrounded by, make the effort. Great love is worth taking the steps you're guided to take. it's possible he needs time to himself to come to whatever that decision is, or to, you know, get on top of that business he needs to handle. In his subconscious, his trust, this situation is calling for you to have faith. Honey, you as children, your love life is being affected by children. And right here was where we had that other card about being impressionable upon children with your teaching. So these can be the same children. Again, they can be yours. They can be his. They can be, you know, neither of the two. They can be an actual class of children that you decide to teach. Surrounding you is very soon. Clearly decide what you want so that it comes to you now. And in your subconscious, codependency, addictions are affecting your romantic life. This can be, because it's the first thing that came to my mind, codependency upon a former partner. These may indeed be your children, and maybe you're codependent upon their father. Maybe that's from who you need to cut energetic ties at the very least, if there's not other ties, if there's not legal ties, like the Justice card would suggest. Crowning. Express your love. Go ahead and make the romantic gesture. At the root, finances and career. Financial issues are a factor in your love life right now. If these are your children, he may be thinking about that too, about taking them on, you know, the package that is you with regard to finances and career. You know, how do I take care of this family? At the heart of the matter, the heart-to-heart conversations. If you honestly discuss your feelings with each other, you guys can come up with answers to all of this. But let's see if we can clarify first ourselves the codependency. Passion. The next card is upside down. Interesting. Let me take this away. The playfulness, our overall energy, and do some shuffle. Well, maybe they want me to do it this way, from the bottom instead of the top this time. Okay, these are upright. Keep an open mind. Your soulmate, who we just saw, evidence of this, may differ from your usual type and expectations. Deception. Someone is wearing a false self mask in this relationship. Romantic feelings. Your feelings are real and worth exploring. So maybe deception is to you, like lying to yourselves. Give your relationship a chance. Work on your partnership. And the next one is upside down, so I won't. But it was pay attention to the red flags. So the passion is there. You saw the feelings are real. Everything is there. The recipe is there. Maybe that's where nutrition comes in. The recipe is there, but you guys gotta put in the work by clearing your energy and making an effort to come together for the heart-to-heart conversations, all of that. You know, it's not gonna just materialize on its own. Okay, the masculine's advice from the romance angels is true love. This is the romance of a lifetime. To you, love yourself first. So again, if you've been living and or loving for other people, like a former spouse or a current spouse, from whom you need to divorce, and maybe for your children, living and loving for your children, or think you're doing it for them, maybe that's part of the deception, convincing yourself that it's for them, because it's really never not. Children are not, you know, they usually are far more sensitive, to use that word, to these things than we are, and they can tell where there's a happy home and where there's not, and all that kind of stuff, where there's love and where there's not. And I think, it's my opinion, we serve them best, and I'm guilty of not having served mine best for some time too, you know, so I'm not chastising you, I'm just making recommendations. We serve them best when we ensure that they're only surrounded by, you know, happy people and love. And sometimes that means separating from their other parent. From the angels, they say body work. So this can be a career possibility for you, or you may be in need of this. Sometimes when I look at this word, body work, and I feel this card and touch it, I feel like tattoos and all that kind of stuff. That's not what I'm feeling now. The first thing I thought was massage. And I mentioned massage therapists earlier. So that may be something you want to look into for yourself to maybe help to clear and heal your energy, if not as a career possibility. Your love life, I'm sorry, your life purpose involves body work, such as massage therapy, energy healing, physical therapy, and or exercise training. And to the masculine, the angels say freedom. You're free to do what you choose. Maybe that's something he needs to hear. And the Ten of Air. So possibly betrayal that he's feeling at, you know, the, not behest, but at the hand, maybe rather, of a air sign, of a Gemini, maybe, is coming to an end. The end of a difficult situation. Embrace the change and expect things to get better now. And he may even be recovering from an addiction. That can be part of the codependency that's affecting your life as well. Addiction doesn't have to be like a substance or something. But on the very positive side and the happy ending, the Six of Water. So another soulmate card for you. Memories from your history or childhood. Issues regarding children. So that could be coming up yet a third time here. Some sort of family court issue that you are guided to pursue and will work in your favor. I hope that this reading provides you answers and you enjoy it and are encouraged by it. Namaste, Angel.